Scoot, happy life day. 20 years. What a journey it's been. Well, it'll be hard to sum up what you mean to me and what the last 20 years have meant, you know, in a short video, but I'll give it a go. A lot of people didn't know you before your accident. Same awesome personality, you know, phenomenal athlete, you know, awesome basketball player, football player. But as you know, as mom coined us, the womb mates, we've been by each other's side since day one, but not on that day. Friggin' play practice saved one of our lives. But you know, many times over the last 20 years, I've asked God, you know, why didn't you just swap me? And I think it's maybe taken two decades to realize that nobody could have taken your place and then lived the life that you've lived. You know, all the traveling you've done, it's all the little things you do for people. I mean, you lighten anyone's path that you cross. And that's why you're so special to all of us and why this day is so special, because personally, I'd be lost if you were taken from us 20 years ago. I know people see how strong you are, but if they could just have a glimpse of just a day in the life of Scoot and watch you, you know, do the dishes and fold your laundry and brush your teeth, I think they'd even be more impressed. But what I love about you most, you never complain. You know, I know you're in constant pain, but you keep moving forward and living life beyond to the fullest, not even like a normal person. And that's why we love you. And so before this turns into Niagara Falls, I want to say salute, Slancha. Got to give a dome call. I love you, Scoot. Happy Life Day, Scoot. Can't wait for 50 more years of you kicking my butt on the golf course. love you, brother. And I know it's been a crazy, you know, last year. We couldn't get together and have a big celebration for you, but a lot of people still wanted to send their love. So enjoy.
All right.
Scoot, happy life day, buddy. We love you. Coming to you live from sunny Florida. We're going to do the dome call for you.
Love you, Scoot.
Buddy dome calls.
Early
love you.
Early in the morning, 10 a.m.
Scooty, glad you're alive, my brother. Happy life day. Can't wait to do some domers with you. See you soon, buddy.
Scoot, happy life day, brother. You're the toughest SOB that I know. I got nothing but love and mad respect for you for everything you do. Me and Mary love you so much. Can't wait to see you soon. Love you, bro.
Scooty, happy life day, brother. Looking forward to some dome calls and some golf here.
Scooty, what's up, man? I was told to keep it short, so I'm going to try. But happy life day, 20 years. Couldn't imagine a day without you, bud. The memories and just all the laughs and the great times. Most of it includes you and your family. So, you know, I love you, kid. Special domer for you. Love you, bud.
Happy life day, Uncle Scott. We love you.
Wow, 20 years. We love you and couldn't imagine it without you.
Dome call.
Cheers.
For you.
Oh, not him yet.
Real American. Fight for what's right. Fight for your life.
Hey, brother. You know who it is. It's the Hulkster. It's Cossamania. It's Mikey Co. Here to tell you something, dude. And that something is to have a happy life day. The Hulkster proposes a toast to my main man, Scooty. So here's to you, dude. Happy life day. And what you gonna do when Hulkamania and Scooty on life day run wild on you? Dude.
Happy life day, Scoot. Love you, brother.
Scoot, my dog, Smaltzy. Happy life day, brother. You've done so much for so many people. So grateful to have you in my life for this long, bro. I have so much love for you, so much respect for you. Just so blessed to have you a part of my life, dude. You're just an inspiration. So I just wanted to let you know I'm in Miami. I'm on the move. And I wanted to give you a shout out, man. And God bless you. I love you. Keep being you.
Hey, Scooter Buns. Jew from the Bronx here. Wanted to wish you a happy life day today. And here's to many more, buddy. Love you.
Hi, Scooty. Happy 20th life day. Boy, has time flown. I remember, like yesterday, your surprise 10th anniversary. And that surprise party on Hazel. Just wanted to drop you a little line and let you know that, you know, this past year has been filled with so much uncertainty and tragedy and death, and it's been hard to focus on what you're most thankful for and hard to stay positive. But I think it's important that you know that when I count my blessings, I count you twice. And I love you very much, and I hope you get to spend the day with the people you love the most and the ones closest to you. And I pray that when this is all over, you get that butt to Columbus and wrestle my babies and play beer pong with Jared. And let's just forget about this year for a little while. So I love you. I hope you have a great day. And hopefully I'll see you soon. Bye.
Scotty, my man. Happy life day, bro. Keep living every day to the fullest. Keep doing the best you, and I love you.
Scoot, the first time I ever met you was at Cook's party in his basement with a Yao Ming beer bong. And you chugged a pitcher of beer and threw it through the wall and put a huge hole in the wall. Then on the night home, I found you passed out in the middle of the street with a car running behind the wheel. Luckily, you woke up the next day in somebody's driveway, passed out with the car still running. But I'll never forget the first night that I ever met you. And I'm glad that I did. And every single time we're together, you never disappoint. I love you, Scooty. Happy life day, brother. Can't wait to celebrate with you.
Hey, Scooty. It's your favorite British pop star, wannabe Spice Girl, Kylie Minogue. Want to wish you a happy life day, buddy. And I love you.
Hey, Scotty. Just wanted to, drop you a little note here. You know, wish you whatever the day we call it, happy life day or whatever it is. But, you know, number one, I want to tell you how much I love you, how proud I am to be a part of your life, to be your friend. And, you know, the lessons that you've taught me in perseverance, toughness, I've always admired the way that you've worked. But I've always really admired the way that you've never been a victim to the circumstance that you've had. And you really have taught me a lot about perseverance and character. And, I'm just really glad you're here with us today and love you, buddy.
Scooter Buns, happy life day. Miss you, buddy. It's been a long ride. Glad you're here. Can't wait to have some more memories with you. Love you, bud.
So the story of Rockout. Joe, Kyle, and I were going to Columbus for a golf outing tournament, And Joe says he needed to pick up one of his friends. He was going to go down to Columbus and hang out for the weekend. So Scott gets in the car. We're driving down to Columbus. Scott's talking nonstop, saying, "Hey, Joe, this is going to rock out this weekend. We're going to rock out this weekend. Last time I was down in Columbus, we rocked out. Went to my buddy's apartment, rocked out. Met some chicks, rocked out. Went to the restaurant, rocked out. Everything was complete rock out, rock out, rocked out, rocked out." So Joe and I stopped to get gas. I said, "Joe, what is up with this dude?" I said, "What does rock out even mean?" Joe chuckled, started laughing, said, "It just means good. It's great. Everything's great. Good deal." So, not knowing Scott at all, I just start calling rock out. Every day I talk to Joe. I said, "Joe, what's that dude's name we went to Columbus with?" "Oh, yeah, that rock out dude. What's that?" So that's the story of rock out. Love you, Scott. Happy life day.
Scoot, Jim, and Tommy Sanders coming at you from Mexico. Happy life day, brother. 20 years. It's incredible. I've truly enjoyed getting to know you and getting to be friends with you over the last several years. And you're an inspiration to all of us, brother. We love you. You say hi? Tommy loves you too, I promise.
What's up, my man, Scott? I just wanted to say happy life day, brother. Love you. Let's
happy
go.
Happy life day, Scotty.
Yo, buddy. Happy life day.
We love you. Happy 20 years. Couldn't be more pleased that you're here with us to be an incredible friend, an incredible son, an uncle, a brother, all of the things that you are. Everybody treasures you so much.
So well said. I have nothing to add other than so excited and proud and happy to know you, and we love you, bud.
Yes.
Really.
Love you.
Scoot, happy 20th life day. You are one of my dearest and oldest friends, and I wish we were celebrating in person, but I'm honored to be asked to take part in the virtual celebration. You live your life with such an infectious joy and love, and I'm so thankful for our friendship. Happy life day. Love you. Hope to see you soon.
Hey, Scoot. It's a big anniversary you have here. I want to say we love you, and we're happy you're alive. Keep being a rock star, buddy. Love you.
Scott, happy life day, buddy. Miss you, love you, hope all is well.
Scoot, 20 years. Happy life day. Looking back, man, all these old times, beginning of football, and all these other fun times we had as we were getting ready. Getting ready for, you know, concerts and music festivals and rocking out after. That leads into college, hanging out all the time in Athens and Columbus. Led us to a couple questionable decisions, but that's enough of the pictures. After that, man, you've always been someone who's always been there for me and for everybody. Just a classic good person. And for that, dome me up, buddy.
Happy life day, Scooty.
We love you.
Love you, man. Enjoy.
My main man, Scoot. Man, I can't tell you how much it's a blessing to know you, for you to be in my life. I remember growing up, fifth, sixth grade, playing basketball. I couldn't stand you and Rob because y'all beat the shit out of me playing basketball. Only to know that y'all would grow up to be one of my brothers that I would go to war with anybody. I couldn't imagine life without you. And I definitely know that you have always been the life of the fucking party, no matter where you went, man, no matter where you've been. Love you. Happy life day, man.
Hey, Scoot. Cheers to 20 years. Happy life day. Let's keep living it to the fullest. That's about it.
We all know every day is a good day. And the best thing in life is life. What's up, player? Hey, brother, just want to give you a quick shout out. Happy life day. You're a true inspiration, unstoppable OG, man. One of the most beautiful minds and souls you'll ever meet. Just a gracious, kind-hearted, and just a freaking amazing personality, man, top to bottom. So just wanted to give you a quick shout, brother. And just know that you're my A1 day one. Peace and love, man. And as always, A-Town Dow. Live it up, brother.
Happy life day, Scooty. We love you.
All I gotta say is L'chaim. Top of the town. Happy Life Day. Dove Life Day. Northside up. Beat Mooney. Fuck Boardman. Still Valley. All Valley. Let's go. Solante. Silente, Slunch.
Hey, Scott, from the Neelys, we wanted to just say Happy Life Day, and you've been so wonderful to us over the last 20 years, and we love you very much. We'll talk to you soon. See you, Tuna.
Scott, Scoot, what's up, man? How you doing, buddy? Hey, Happy Life Day. I just wanted to give you a shout-out, let you know how much I love you, and I appreciate you, and couldn't imagine going through this crazy world without you. We've definitely had some epic journeys, epic trips, and I can't wait to add to that. So just wanted to let you know how much I love you, baby, and to wish you a happy life day and make the best out of it. And be sure to get a hold of me so I can join in with all the fun. So, all right, buddy, you have a good one. We love you. Take care of yourself, and I will talk to you soon. All right, buddy. Bye.
Happy Life Day, Brady. We're so lucky that you're such a fighter because the world is a much better place with you in it. Sending you all my love.
Hey, Scott, how you doing? Robbie said I only have 5 seconds, so I don't know how I'm going to do this, but I just want to wish you a happy Life Day. I'm really glad you made it because we need all the 5%ers we can get. You're one of the all-time best. God bless you. Can't wait to have dinner with you. Hang in there, boss.
Chicken wing, hot dog and bologna, Scooty likes macaroni, happy life day for my homie. Ooh, didn't know where I was going with that one for a second. Scooty Buns, happy life day, buddy. I love you. Couldn't imagine this world without you, man. One of a kind. I love you, brother. Happy life day. Dome call.
Hey, Scotty. Happy life day. I hope you have an amazing day and know that nothing else matters today but you. Thinking about you so much today and love you and miss you.
Scooty Big Nut.
Happy life day, brother. Short and sweet, you're a beast. Love you, man.
What's up, Scooty? Just want to wish you a happy 20th anniversary of Life Day. I know we're celebrating 20 years, but man, every day with you has been an awesome blessing. So I love you more than you'll ever know, and definitely glad that we still get to do some dome calls together.
Boo, boo, boo!
Scoot Magoo, the man, the myth, the legend, the miracle. Hey, brother, happy Life Day, 20th Annie. You the man out here in the golf course, smacking them around. Hope you have a great day, brother. Love you. From Columbus.
Bringing a dance party to you. Happy Life Day, Scoot. Love you.
Hey, brother. Love you. Sorry I'm running late. I'm still working. Danielle's mad at me. She wanted to be in the video, but she put self-tanner on because I forgot to tell her about this video. So she's pissed, but she said she looks orange, but she loves you, and I love you, and congratulations, and we're going to have a good time on Sunday. See you then.
Wait. Okay, now go.
Hey, Scott, I'm so glad you're feeling well and everything's good. Love you.
Happy Life Day, Uncle Scotty.
Happy Life Day, brother. Keep being an inspiration, and we love you.
Love you.
Hi, Scoot.
Hi, Scoot.
We want to wish you a happy Life Day, and this world's a better place because you're in it. Dome call for you, buddy. And this is Baby Rourke's first dome call. Right here. For you.
What's up, Scooty? Happy Life Day, brother. Love you.
Hi, Scott. Happy Wife Day. Or is it Life Day? Or is it Life with a Wife Day? Life without a wife. Anyhow, Happy Life Day.
Oh, we love you, honey. Thinking about you this weekend. I can't believe it's 20 years. Love you now. Bye-bye.
Scoot. Happy 20, man. Lots of love from Boston, from Ari and Dana. And hope you have a great day, man.
Hey, Scott, happy life day. I just want to let you know how much I love you and care for you. You are one of the most funniest, caring people that I've ever known. You know, I remember back years ago, before we even really knew each other, I'd be sneaking into McMenemy's to come to your and Rob's parties. It was like the highlight of the year. Everyone wanted to go. You know, it's still the same to this day. You're the life of the party. You always have a good time. You're always making everyone around you laugh. And you really go above and beyond for all of your friends and everyone in your life. And just let you know how appreciated you are and how cared for you are. Love you so much. Have a good one.
Scott, you old son of a bitch. Happy Life Day.
Scoot, me and Gus here, all the way from San Francisco. Just wanted to say that can't believe it's been 20 years, and every second that you've been alive in this life, you've made this world a better place. You've made all of us better people. So, you know, we love you, and here's a many, many, many more. Domer! Domer!
What's up, Scoot? Just want to pop over, give you a quick little video, just to give you a little happy 20-year life anniversary. Man, it just seems like yesterday, you know, I remember getting the call and hearing about everything and coming by the hospital to see you. And it's been a, you know, I know a long, strenuous 20 years for you, but man, you've made the most of it and kept a smile on your face from day one. You are the true definition of perseverance and determination, man. This world is a better place with you in it. And I know, you know, people have talked to you and know what's going on. Just, you know, they can't give up when they see someone like you going as hard as you do. So today, my friend, do a quick little cheers, maybe a little mini dome call per se. So this one's for you. Congratulations, buddy. Love you to death.
Yo, Scoot, happy life day, brother. We love you and we salute you.
Hey, Scoot, happy life day. I cannot believe it's been 20 years since your accident. I obviously didn't know you back then, but I've gotten to know you a lot over the last decade, and I've learned a lot about your story and everything that happened 20 years ago. And it's just truly incredible the obstacles that you've overcome and just how you live your life every single day moving forward. You not only survive, but you thrive. And your zest for life is completely amazing. And, you know, you inspire everybody who knows you every single day. And I'm just really grateful to not only know you, but call you family. And I love you, and I hope you have an awesome
years.
Day.
Man, 20 years. Wow. I can't believe it's been 20 years. I remember exactly where I was when I got that call. I was at BG in my apartment. I think I was actually by myself. And Mom called and said you were in a really bad accident. I actually just thought about getting in my car and driving home, but I knew there was nothing I can do. At that point, they didn't even know. You were still intubated, had the breathing tube. You were at St. E's and they were concerned about your brain bleed. That was before they even transferred you up to Metro. And then talked to her for a while and she called back and said that they were gonna life flight you to Cleveland, which I knew was good because they could handle it better than St. E's could. Of course, we didn't know the extent of everything at that point. I just knew it was just a horrible feeling, a feeling that I never wanted to experience. But then I came and saw you at Metro, and I could tell you were changed forever, but I knew that if there was anyone that could deal with what you were about to deal with, you were the one. I even saw you a couple times in the rehab when you stayed in the rehab facility, and you could just see how hard you were trying and the pain and the anguish and everything that you put into trying to rehab and just get back to being normal. And that's just commendable. Not many people could do that. That's just the acute rehab phase of getting through what you were just through. And then fast forward as the years go on, you just have accomplished more than I think anyone ever thought you could. No one ever looks at you and thinks that you have a disability because you are just you. You do you better than most people do themselves. It's that resiliency and that determination that make you who you are. And this world would be totally different if your life was taken that day. And I thank God a lot that we still have you and we're fortunate enough to call you family. I just want to wish you a happy life day. I love you. And hopefully in this year we'll get to see you a lot more than we did this past year. And you get to hang out with the boys and Kenley. And we'll just be normal. I love you, Scoot. Enjoy your day. 20 years.
Hey, Scooty, a happy life day, brother. Happy Masters Week. But most importantly, happy life day. Happy 20th life day. 20 years, I can't believe it. I've been thinking about you a lot this week. I thought there's a couple things that came to mind that I wanted to share with you. I remember 20 years ago this week, I was in Biloxi, Mississippi. My sister Beth and John and their kids were living there at the Air Force Base, wherever that's at. And we were off school that week, and Rob Heckle and I went down to hang out with them and spend the week down there. And we got back, my mom picked us up from the Pittsburgh airport, and we were driving home, talking, you know, about the trip and whatnot. My mom said, you know, by the way, hey, do you guys know who Scott Smaltz is? Of course, you know, we weren't close at the time, but of course, I mean, no surprise, everybody knows who you guys are. Yeah, we know who Scott is. And then she proceeded to tell us about your accident. We had heard nothing about it. We were away, no local news, no newspaper. And, you know, it was pretty shocking at the time. And, you know, I just remember wanting to know more, hoping that you were okay, not really knowing you, but just, you know, we had some common friends and knowing that you guys are good people and, you know, hoping that everything was all right. You know, and then everybody, you know, fast forward throughout the summer, you know, everything that went on in your recovery. But not being close to you, we really had no idea what was going on, just hoping for the best and hoping you were okay. And I remember, I think it was Sadie Hawkins, I guess that would have been, I think it was, that we were at a dance in the cafeteria in the fall. And I was standing by, I was standing by the vending machines. So if you're facing the vending machines, the entrance to the cafeteria is over to the right. And I remember looking over to my right and seeing you kind of, you just walking in. I can still kind of picture it, you know, like Scoot swag a little bit. And you're wearing a fucking tiger outfit. And I remember just being like, holy shit, that guy's here. And he's okay. He's here and he's okay. And by the way, he's wearing a tiger. He's like wearing a tiger outfit. That's the coolest thing ever. Like, this horrific thing happened to him. He's all right. And he's here just like to have fun. And I remember thinking so many things. I remember thinking, I literally thought to myself, I wish I was cool enough to show up here by myself in a tiger outfit. You know, you're in high school and it's all about your image and how, you know, what you think that people perceive you as. And this was probably the first time I saw, you know, like got a taste of you and Rob, just, you know, like the way you two are and being yourselves and, you know, not thinking of how people perceive you, but just wanting to have fun and just being yourselves. And I also remember thinking, like, I want to go tell that guy, hey, I'm glad you're here. It's fucking great to see you, even though I don't know you. And me being is like shy and, you know, kind of reserved as I was in high school, I would never do that. I wouldn't just go up to somebody that I never spoke to before and talk to them. But I just remember thinking how cool that was. And fast forward 20 years later, and you're one of the best men at my wedding and my best friend and my brother. And I look back and I just can't imagine what the last 20 years would have been like without you. You're an influential part of my life. I look up to you. You're a role model. You and the way you live your life and the outlook on life and the way you treat people and stay connected with your friends, I look up to all of that. And I you know, Scott, it's tough to find the words to say to let you know the light that you bring to all of us when you're around. Everything, every little detail, from your Christmas cards to your costumes to, you know, just the little things. You remembered everybody's favorite cereal growing up and sent it to people as Christmas presents. Like, just ridiculous, thoughtful things that I don't know if you'll ever realize the light that you are to so many people's lives. And I just couldn't imagine the last 20 years without you. Happy Life Day, brother. Here's to 20 years, and here's to 20 more. Love you, man.
Happy
Life Day, Scotty.
20 years.
20 years.
Wow. Okay. Take it, honey.
Hi, Scotty. I just want you to know I'm grateful to God for saving you on April the 10th, 2001. And I'm even grateful to you, Scotty, for taking that life and with that life being the kind of person you are today. Such a wonderful, loving, considerate, kind person. I'm so happy to be able to have this moment to tell you how I strongly feel about you, Scotty. I'm so grateful that God has blessed me with such a wonderful son. I feel that you are very strong and you have been through so much adversity in your life. And yet you have been persevering and so perseverance and determined to be the great person that you are. And I'm so happy that I could say that I am your father and that you are my son, Scotty. I love you, Scotty, very much, and continue to be the way you are for the next 20, for the rest of your life. Okay, Scotty.
That was good.
I better get out of the way now.
No, you don't have to get out of the way. Okay. Hi, Scotty. I'm gonna put up a few pictures here, because, you know, I have a lot of pictures. Okay, the bottom one says April 10th, 2001, like Pearl Harbor, a day that will live in infamy for us. Thank you. from my poem. What's the matter, huh? That was the day of your surgery. Have a lot of other pictures, but I don't know that you would. You had a lot of people concerned with you. A lot of visitors at Hillside. Where'd we go? We were there. My birthday. Rehab, you had to apparently learn to walk and go up steps again. That was Hillside. You got famous, got your name in the paper, not for good reason, but they weren't going to let you go to prom. They thought it was too much stimulus for you all at once. All those kids, all that dancing. But then they let you go, said just go to prom. And of course, 12, 13 hours later, we brought you back.
That's backwards.
I don't know. It's not backwards. Oops. And then they finally let you go home. And you finally got your jaws unwired. That was your first bite of food. You lost 40 pounds. They said give you chicken broth, and we took you to get chimichangas. Again, a picture of your surgery, your recuperation, sort of, in the hospital. Kristen was a big part of your life then. This is one of my favorite pictures because I likened you to the Energizer Bunny. You kept on going. Never run out. It was right after they ripped out your chest tube. It wasn't good. That's home. Had a lot of visitors. A lot of people care about you. Second surgery, find out why the first one didn't work. Trying to rehab at Ohio State.
And I do it one
no,
more time.
No, I didn't talk yet. Time. I didn't talk yet.
Oh.
Jeez. Wow, 20 years, Scotty, and it must seem like 100 to you. And when I think about how every day of those 20 years you've lived in pain, and but you have the Smaltz heart and you're my hero. You have that indomitable spirit and never give up. You never wanted sympathy, and you always took, no pun intended, great pains to show that you could do anything, mostly anything else anyone else could do, and you never complained. 20 years ago today, this is what they gave me at the hospital. When I finally got there, medical personnel gave me the clothes that they cut off you in this little neat package. And there's the dried blood. And I've never opened it, and I've never thrown it away, and can't find your medical records again. But geez, I got these clothes, and I don't know why I kept them, but you're just my hero. You've gone through so much, and I was privileged to know kind of more than, I don't want to say anyone else, I would say except Robbie, what you went through after you were life-flighted. I got to see firsthand and help you as best I could. And through it all, you're just a miracle. It's a miracle that we have had you for 20 years. And I used to say, why God, why him? And that one, shortly after the accident, you said, why not me? But I do know that it was in God's plan, because you were born to be an inspiration to people, and you have shown that every day of your life by living it, by walking the walk and not complaining. And you've been a gift to everyone who's met you. And you have certainly been a gift to your dad and I and your brothers. And I don't know what we would have done these last 20 years without you. So I'm very thankful for you, Scotty. I still pray that there's a new invention of surgery that comes along one day. You got to still have hope. And thank you for being you. And I love you very much. Happy Life Day, son. Bye.
Bye, Scott.